How are you all? Hope you all are doing well. This is Krishnamurthy. You can call me as VKM. Welcome to Electron Chemistry Center or ECC. It's been a long time. I have not uploaded videos. And after a long time, we are uploading a video which is based on chemical kinetics. In this video, we are going to solve numericals which are important for NEET and JEE mains. Those numericals we are going to solve it from a chapter called Chemical Kinetics, and especially numericals based on activation energy. Numericals based on activation energy, Arrhenius equation. These numericals we are going to solve it. Let's solve the numericals without delaying it. First numerical is the rate of reaction triples, it becomes 3 times when temperature changes from 20 degree Celsius to 50 degree Celsius. Means temperature which is given here, this temperature is T1 and this temperature is T2. So temperature values are given. Calculate the energy of activation. Ea we have to calculate it. R value is given 8.314 joule Kelvin inverse mole inverse. We have a formula, that is log K2 upon K1 is equal to Ea upon 2.303 R of T2 minus T1 upon T1 into T2. This formula has been derived from the Arrhenius equation when two rate constants are given, as well as when two different temperatures are given. So here we have two different temperatures, that's why we took this formula. T1 is equal to 20 degree Celsius at 273, it gives you 293 Kelvin. Similarly, T2 we have 50 degree Celsius, so 50 plus we have 273. Convert into Kelvins, we'll get 323 Kelvins. So now we have K2 upon K1. They mention it very clearly, the rate of reaction triples. Whenever they gave triples or doubled, in such cases K2 upon K1, if it is tripled it should be taken as 3, if it is doubled it should be taken as 2. So K2 upon K1 is 3. Substitute all the values. Log 3 is equal to Ea, we don't know, 2.303 into R value 8.314, it is T2 minus T1, 323 minus 293 upon 293 into 323. These are the values what we are, having, and all the values we have substituted in the formula. And then log 3, 0.4771. is equal to Ea upon 2.303 into 8.314 of 323 minus 293. That gives you how much? 30 upon 293 into 323. Highlight the Ea, then 0.4771 into 2.303 into 8.314 into 293 into 323, all divided by 30. If you solve it, activation energy which gives you 2881.8 joule per mole. Sometimes they will ask you the answer in kilojoules, then you can convert into kilojoules also. 28.811 kilojoule per mole. So this is the final answer what we get it. So these type of questions are very, very important for NEET examination children. Hence we are discussing as a numericals of chemical kinetics chapter, especially numericals based on activation energy, Arrhenius equation we are discussing in this session. Hope you understand this numerical. Similarly, we can solve another numerical also. The next question we have, second one, calculate the rate constant of reaction at 293 Kelvin when the energy of activation is 103 kilojoule per mole and the rate constant at 273 Kelvin is given 7.87 into 10 raised to minus 7 second inverse. See, temperatures are also, you know, two temperatures we have, so two rate constants, but one rate constant is known to us, another rate constant we have to find it out. One rate constant which is known to us, that is K1 at 273 Kelvin, is 7.87 into 10 raised to minus 7 second inverse. Similarly, K2 at 293 Kelvin we have to identify. But activation energy they gave 103 kilojoule per mole. So R value should be taken in kilojoule. So 8.314 into 10 raised to minus 3 kilojoule per mole. Right? So T1, what is the T1 we have? 273 Kelvin. And T2 we have 293 Kelvin. Hope this is clear. So now we have to use the same formula what we have used in the previous numerical. Log K2 by K1 is equal to Ea upon 2.303 R of T2 minus T1 upon T1 into T2. So then log K2, K2 we don't know, but K1 we know, that is 7.87 into 10 raised to minus 7 is equal to Ea. Ea we have how much? 103 upon 2.303. R value is how much? 8.314 into 10 raised to minus 3 of T2 minus T1, that is 293 minus 273 upon 293 into 273. Either T1 into T2 or T2 into T1 doesn't make difference. So now if we solve, we have this side log K2 upon 7.87 into 10 raised to minus 7. If you solve this whole, you know, data, you will get it as this one, 103 of this temperature difference and everything, you will get around 1.345. This is what we are going to get it, right? So then we have log this side, so that log should be cancelled. Take anti-log on both sides. If you take anti-log on both sides, that side log will be cancelled. K2 upon 7.87 into 10 raised to minus 7 is equal to anti-log of 1.345. If we solve this, the whole data, you will get it, K2 is equal to 1.74 into 10 raised to minus 5 second inverse. This is what we are going to get it. It is another way of asking numerical. In the previous question, they asked about, you know, K2 upon K1, they gave tripled. Similarly, they may give doubled also. In this numerical, they gave one rate constant. They asked us to find it out in another rate constant. It's another way of asking numerical based on activation energy. Hope you understand, right? It is second numerical. Now, let's solve the third one. The next question we have, for a gaseous reaction, following data is given. A giving rise to B, K1 is equal to 10 raised to 15 into E raised to minus 2000 upon T. Similarly, C upon D, C giving rise to D, K2 is equal to 10 raised to 14 into E raised to minus 1000 upon T. The temperature at which K1 is equal to K2. K1 must be, first rate constant must be equal to second rate constant at what temperature? So then, K1 is equal to K2 in the sense, what we have K1? 10 to the power of 15 into e raised to minus 2000 upon T is equal to K2 10 raised to 14 e raised to minus 1000 upon T. Right. So then 10 raised to 15 upon 10 raised to 14 is equal to e raised to minus 1000 upon T upon e raised to minus 2000 upon T. This will give you 10, right? And this will give you minus 1000 plus 2000. So it gives you 1000 upon T. So E stands for here natural logarithm, ln E, right? Now if you convert into logarithmic form, log base 10 form, then you will get 2.303 into log 10 is equal to 1000 upon t. That ln e will be cancelled here. So we know, and brackets I am writing here, log 10 is equal to 1, but we need a temperature. Temperature will be equal to what will be getting 1000 upon 2.303. If you solve it, 1000 upon 2.303, if you solve it, you will get 434.2 kelvins. It is the answer. It's another way of asking a question based on this Arrhenius equation or activation energy or rate constant numericals, whatever you say. It's a third way of asking numerical. Hope you understand this numerical. Similarly, we can solve another numerical also. Let's see the next numerical we have. Fourth one. For a reaction, A is equal to 0. Very simple and important numerical. K is equal to 3.2 into 10 to the power of 4 second inverse at 300 Kelvin. The value of K at 310 Kelvin would be. We have formula K is equal to A into e raised to minus Ea by RT. Right? So then Ea will be equal to 0, right? If Ea is equal to 0 in the sense, the whole it will be e raised to 0 actually. Minus Ea by RT will be equal to 0. Then e raised to 0 will be equal to 1. Then K will be equal to A. So at 300 Kelvin, whatever the K value we have, and the same value will be there for at 310 Kelvin also, because K is equal to Arrhenius factor. So then K 300 will be equal to K 310 Kelvin. Then so K will be at 310 Kelvin, it will be equal to 3.2 into 10 raised to 4 second inverse. This is what we can give it, right? Because K is equal to A, right? So the same thing will be applicable here also, and K is equal to A, we will get the same value. Hope you understand this. It's very simple, but it's very important numerical. Generally they used to ask in NEET as well as in JE mains also. It is also another question we can say based on Arrhenius equation or rate constant or activation energy. Let's solve another numerical also. The next numerical we have for N2 plus 3H2. Synthesis of ammonia giving rise to 2NH3 plus 22 kilocalorie. Whenever they gave along with the reaction, then delta H can be written as minus 22 kilocalorie. Ea for this, activation energy for this reaction is 70 kilocalorie. You can say this is forward reaction. Hence the activation energy for this reaction, 2NH3 giving rise to N2 plus 3H2. So this is called a backward reaction if you observe it, reverse reaction, right? Activation energy of backward reaction they are asking. It's a very important numerical, children, for CET. For CET exams, it's very important numerical. So we have a formula, delta H is equal to activation energy of forward reaction minus activation energy of backward reaction. Delta H we have minus 22. Forward reaction we have 70 kilocalorie minus activation energy of backward. Then do the calculation. Activation energy of backward reaction is equal to 70 plus 22, which gives you 92 kilocalorie. Right? So it is the answer, 92 kilocalorie. Hope you understand. So these are the numericals which are very important for based on activation energy, rate constant, and Arrhenius equation. Hope you enjoyed the session. And if you like the video, please click on the like button. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. If you have any doubts, please post it in the comment box or in the live chat if it is a premiere. So in the next lecture, we will be discussing more numericals related to chemical kinetics chapter. So please follow my channel. Until then, take care. Signing off. Bye-bye.